Hello everybody, I am Fedora Gamer, and it is Friday again. Not any Friday, today is Black Friday. I hope you guys had a good Black Friday and avoided being trampled by herds of human cattle for the shiniest new electronic, etc., etc. But I have a deal for you that Walmart can't beat. How about a game for free, like we do every Friday that I don't forget slash miss doing it. But today we are looking at Petrichor, which, if you don't know what Petrichor is, it means the pleasant smell accompanied by rain, pretty much. So it's the smell of rain, which is a fantastic rain. So let's go ahead and jump into it. I have not played this any myself, but the fantastic pixel art caught my eye and got me very interested. Okay, looks like it's mouse-driven. Go pick up the umbrella. Seems like a good idea since it's raining out. Oh, and apparently rain's fine, but streams of water dematerializes you. That was a hard word for some reason. Looks like we have a note in the mud here. Okay. Can we go up here? Sit by the fire some more? Oh, hey, we have another option. Oh, okay, we can dry out the note here. And it looks like her falling? Jumping? Something like that. Wait. Yep, gotta get the umbrella out. Now we have... Okay, so those notes, drying them out, gives you new abilities. Interesting. I'm really digging the pixel art of this game. It looks fantastic. Sit here. Get warmed up a little bit. I don't have any other notes, so... Fantastic pixel art. Very mysterious feeling. Kind of gives me a vibe of something like Another World, which is a classic game. Okay, let's jump and get this other note here. This is available on itch.io. It is, it's pay what you want, which includes free. I always recommend if you enjoy a game to throw a few dollars at the developer. Let's go ahead and warm this one up here. Jumping or climbing, something of the sort. Stand back up. It's entirely mouse driven, but I always recommend supporting a developer if you like their work. That way they can continue to make more games. Alright, simple enough. This one's definitely more of the exploration field genre. Oh, we can jump up here. Ooh, there's a rope. Apparently we can't do anything with the rope. I'm guessing we need to learn how from this little piece of paper here. Can we jump down? Nope, we had to go back over here. There is a cool feature on Ichigo, I believe there is, if I'm remembering correctly, if I'm not completely insane, where on a pay-what-you-want game, you can, you know, pay what you want, or nothing, but later go back and change how much you had paid for it, and decide, if you like the game, pay some more. Okay, we can now hook onto a chain, it appears. We should probably... Okay, turn off the water. Apparently we didn't find what we need to go up that rope, though. Ooh, it's a rather big cave. There's a floating magic rock thing. Kind of scared of it. Honestly, I'm kind of really... Don't fall on me. We have another chain here. Interesting. A little bit of very basic puzzle gameplay. I'm really digging the mysterious atmosphere. Now there's a giant mushroom there. Yeah, it definitely feels mysterious and otherworldly. And clouds. Very low floating clouds. Hey, we have another fireplace here. So it doesn't appear to be completely linear. It looks like you have some branching paths going on here. Let's okay. I don't know how this will help, but let's try that. Okay. The dematerializing is a little disconcerting. So clearly we'll have to find something that allows us to walk on clouds. That's not actually possible? Interesting. I do kind of wonder if I could have gone up that rope, or if it's something I'm going to have to backtrack to later. Man, the pixel art is so good, though. The artist of this game, very talented person. Okay. These magic chains that make things happen. When are we going to find another page here? There's another unlit fireplace and a rock with 7 in it. Okay, but that's an unlit fireplace, unfortunately. Interesting. This is going to be a rather short game. The page, I read a little bit of it, did say that it's intended to be played in one short sitting. So it's definitely not going to be a long game. There's no saving functionality due to that. So we had to backtrack quite a bit to be able to see what that page does. What does the page give us? Click, click. Not sure what that means. Allows us to run. That's somewhat interesting. I'll go back to that rope. See if the chain ability lets me climb up the rope as well. Hook out. Oh, yep, we gotta hook that. Jumpy jumpy. I'm still very confused by the floating rock. Is it eyes? I don't know. It might have eyes. Let's go see if we can do anything over here. Nope, we still can't. So that's something we need to find another page for. I'm not sure how being able to run helps our progression. That's kind of not what was blocking me. Interesting. We don't need to pull that. We do need to pull this one. Also, that mushroom has a glowy thing on it. And I guess there's got to be something that requires running for us to progress here. What is it? I mean, there's another page up there, but I have no idea how to get to up there. Oh, running probably lets us get across those clouds. Because that's exactly how you walk on clouds. You just have to run. Alright, let's go try it out. Let's go see what that giant magic mushroom has for us here. Interesting. What are you? Oh. Yes, run, please. Okay. Let's go see if we can read. It looked like a book, maybe. Let's see if that can be used down here. At the fireplace. Or the campfire. Nope. So I'm not entirely sure what that was. There did appear to be another one on top of the floating rock, so let's go back, perhaps, and see if there's some interaction there. The running is useful for getting around a lot faster as well. Nope, does not appear to be any interaction with it. But there's definitely another one on top of it for us to get. Well, I think I'm going to end this video here. I don't want to completely ruin the game for you guys. It is a short experience, so I highly recommend going and grabbing it. And if you enjoy it, to throw a couple dollars at the developer. I've been Fedora Gamer. If you liked this video, please like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys next time.